going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes, and Peter Piper plus one. We are in the Rockaways right now, heading into Rockaway Beach. We're actually going to a commercial client of ours. I've been out here a few times already. They got a Weil McLain Ultra 3. Oh, just a matter of time before that bad boy has got a hold the bottom of it. You know what? We actually never actually bothered to look the last time. I was there last time. I never bothered to look last time, but these Weil McLain Ultra 3s, they got a problem. You know, that highly acidic condensate eats the bottom of the heat exchanger. You know, at least Death Box Incorporated's, you know, machines don't rot out like that, but customer has no heat or hot water. Let's go see what's going on. And please take a moment to hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already. If you enjoy this channel, it really would help out with the way the channel reaches the audience like yourself. It really helps with that Google search algorithms and all that other inner workings of the Google and the YouTube. But we're also, it'll help reaching our next milestone, which is 100,000 subscribers. And the goal is within 6 months, and that's by May 1st, 2023. So please be kind and subscribe. All right, let's see. Peter, I need a small flat screwdriver to pick this open and see if any cucarachas here today. No cucarachas?
There were cucarachas last
week. They were, right?
Was there?
Yeah, under the waffle maker thing here. It's fucking gross, by the way. Let's go see what we got going on in here. Cucarachas, there we go. Oh, the cover's off. Who took the cover off? Should I look for any holes? Should I look? Oh, we got some. Got some corrosion. Oh, what's that? Seems like it. Pretty solid there. But all of this drippage appears to be originating right there. But it's on now. Let's check some lockout history. We're gonna hold the up and down buttons. Oh, I think I'll go back, I should go here. Up and down at the main screen. And that'll give us the contractor menu. When I let go of it, there we go. Let's go to diagnostics. Let's go to errors. Lockout history number one was on the 18th. Lockout, just says lockout, let's see. It was a manual reset, auto reset, inputs. Everything in there looks kind of normal. We had a system supply temperature of nothing. System return of 65 degrees. Boiler out of 200. Boiler out 2 of 197. Looks like it was high temperature. That's what happened there. Lockout history number 2. Also on the 18th. We're probably going to have similar temperatures. Yep. And let's go to lockout history number 3. That was an auto reset. Same thing. Let's look at our temperatures now, and we still don't have, we don't have a system supply temperature sensor, and that would be that one right there. This color looks like it's seen better days. But the problem here is that they've been having brownouts, so we're probably going to want to suggest adding a surge protection device here. That would be pretty good because they're having a frequent brownouts and it's affecting all the parameters of the system. So let's go back to our contractor menu one more time. Come on. There we go. Boiler settings, 299. Okay. High temperature limit of 200. Warm weather shutdown of 70. There's no adjustment on the outdoor curve, so that's okay. System settings, okay. We have an indirect. Are we using an indirect? I guess we're using this as an indirect, and this is also, by the way, this is really, really effed up stuff going on here. Like, that is like, that is a huge condensate trap right there. Hit it with a hammer, right? That'll solve the day. All right, that's boiler priority one, boiler priority two. That's fin tube baseboard at 180 degrees. Perfect. Minimum supply is 130. Let's go back to system there three. It's custom temperatures, 190 max. Minimum supply is 70. All right. Looking pretty good right now.
I think those lockouts were from when me and Danny...
Probably.
Because the circulators was off for like 3 seconds.
Yeah. They've been having frequent brownouts here, and a customer called yesterday that the system just says standby, and everything's cold, yet it's calling for domestic hot water and space heating, and nothing's happening. But now it's working, so... But one thing is odd, though. Our pressure is reading nothing. And there's our... Oh, no. That's because we don't have one. We don't have one. Don't!